typical pattern. And for Bank Nifty, today it has like crossed almost all the important levels and managed to close above the previous highest levels of 53,000. So based on its technical formation, the next level to watch out for would be 55,000 for the Bank Nifty. So ideal strategy should be to buy if there is any intraday correction or correction of 1 or 2 days max.
All right. Well, got that. Srikanth, you're sounding fairly optimistic. And if the Nifty and the Nifty Bank need to do well, then the key player will have to be HDFC Bank, which incidentally is the stock of the day. It was up 2% after the latest shareholding pattern showed that the foreign institutional investors currently hold less than 55% stake. This makes them eligible for a potential increase in the MSCI weightage. Abhishek joins us to fill us in with a quick analysis on that. Abhishek, over to you.
Well, HDFC Bank has released their June shareholding, which shows that the FIR holding is below the 55% level. So, June shareholding does indicate that there are chances for weight increase in the MSCI digit, which will happen in August 2024. FIR shareholding as of June is at 54.83%. FIR holding had to fall below 55.5% for the eligibility with respect to MSCI inflow into the bank. So, HDFC Bank is expected to see an inflow of close to $3 to $4 billion, wherein the FIR headroom has slipped below 55%. This creates a headroom of 25%. Just to alert our viewers, a foreign investment ceiling in HDFC Bank is at 74%. Back to you.
Okay, all right. Thanks a lot for that, Abhishek. Well, Mayuresh, what's your view? You know, the stock has been a big outperformer. We were making this point even on a lighter note that in February, around Valentine's Day, it went down to around that sub $1,400 levels. From there, it's given a 25% return. Though in the last 1 year, it's actually not moved a rupee. Because you pull up a 1 year chart, same day last year, it was at around 1,757 rupees. And today, it ended around there. So yes, it made another 52-week high, but it's absolutely at the same level. What's your view on the stock?
No, I think we remain positive, Nigel, on this one. Again, I think the synergies that will build up over the next few quarters, both on the revenue and the cost side, will be significant enough. But it's very early to draw a parallel that the same will start happening for this quarter. And therefore, if investors of the belief that a turnaround should start happening immediately, that's probably not going to happen. But they are going to probably ensure that the cross-selling happens specifically for the HDFC book. There will be some element in terms of recruitment of NIMs as rate cuts happen, as they successfully cross-sell, there will be significant deposit mobilization at lower rates, which they will obviously benefit in terms of their incremental spreads going forward. And therefore, I think these benefits, as they start seeping in over the next few quarters, should incrementally add to the book value of the overall consolidated numbers. Therefore, our take is second half earnings recovery should start taking place. It should be sustainable over the next few quarters. Obviously, a lot of issues that they faced in the past, technological glitches, the glitches in terms of the entire merger and consolidation taking place should largely be over. And therefore, I think numbers should be better as we head to the next few years. So, yeah, I think we remain optimistic on this.
Okay, so remain optimistic on HDFC Bank. Actually, we also caught up with